Hello, my dear students. A very warm welcome to you all. In earlier video, we have learned about verbs. We have discussed that verb is an action word. It tells what the subject does. And we have seen there are two types of verbs. That is main verbs and auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary verbs are further divided into primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. Already we have learned about primary auxiliaries. Today we'll start with modal auxiliaries, or you can call it simply modals or modal verbs. Now, modal verbs are very important in our everyday life. These verbs are not independent. They need an action word to denote recommendation, permission, suggestion, ability, possibility, advice, obligation, etc. So the word modal is derived from modality. A modal verb is used with another verb to indicate its mood. It has no special form in the third person singular, and it does not have a present or past participle form. Okay, so according to the change in the number of person, it doesn't change its forms. Even for third person singular, it remains as it is. It doesn't take S or ES. Okay. And like other verbs have present participle and past participle form, that is ing and third form, modal verbs doesn't have these forms. So the modal verbs are can, could, may, might, must, shall, should, will, would, need, dare. So these are all modal verbs. So we must learn the use of modal verbs. So let's begin with can. Now, when do we use can and when do we use could? So let's see the use of can. Can is used to show ability. I can speak four languages. It means I am able to speak four languages. So to show ability, we use can. Offer. So if you offer something to someone, for example, can I help you? So with authority, you are asking somebody that can I help you. Next, to show the possibility. Smoking can cause cancer. So there is a possibility that due to smoking, it can cause cancer. To show possibility, we use can. Next is request. To make request, can you hand me the pen? So to make request also we use can. Next, permission. So to ask permission or to take permission, we use can. Can I use your book? Okay. So these are the uses of can. Next model is could. Now remember here, can is generally used in present and could indicates past. So to show the ability in the past, we use could. For example, I could play flute when I was a child. So the past ability, in past I had the ability. Okay, so I could play flute when I was a child. So to show the past ability, we use could. Next is suggestion. To give suggestion, I could help you with your homework. Next is possibility. She could buy a pen if she had money. So if she had money, then she could buy a pen. Next is request. To make a request. Could you help me now? So to make a polite request, we use could. Could is more polite than can. Means when you want to speak very humbly, we use could. Next, permission. To take permission. Could we go home now? Okay, so to take permission also we use could. Next is conditional. If we had got up earlier, we could have completed this. So there is a condition. If we could have got up earlier. So in conditional clause also we use could. Now next, third model is may. May is used to show possibility. She may be at home. So it is possible that she may be at home. So to show the possibility, we use may. Then to take permission. May I come in? So whenever you entered the class, you ask your teacher, may I come in? Yes? So you are taking permission. So may is also used to give permission. For example, yes, you may go home now. So for to take permission and to give permission, we can use may. When we are talking to the higher authority, generally we use may. Next, request. May I have the bill, please? So to make a request, we use may. Next, wish. If you have some wish, you are expressing your wish. May God bless you. So for that also we use may. Fourth model is might. Now what is the difference between may and might? Might means you are not firm. You are not sure about it. When you are not sure about something, use might. So might is used to show possibility. It might rain tonight. Means it might. I'm not sure, but it might. So whenever you are not sure, use might. Next, suggestion. You might try the apple pie. Next is conditional. If I entered the contest, I might win. So if I entered the contest, I might win. It's here. I'm not sure, but I might win. Okay. So when there is a lack of surety, when you are not sure about anything, use might. Okay. Now let's move towards our next model verb, that is must. Must is used to show necessity. Something is necessary. For example, you must study before test. See, if you will not study, what will happen? You will not get marks, isn't it? So to score good marks, you must study before test. So it is a necessity. So
in saying must. It is compulsion. Next, certainty. Look at all of that snow. It must be really cold outside. So, if you see snow everywhere, so it is certain that it must be cold, right? So, to show certainty, we use must. Next is prohibition. Prohibition means when you want to stop someone from doing something, prohibit someone from doing something. So that is the negative form. You must not play with fire. Why? Because it is dangerous. So you must not play with fire. You are prohibited from playing with fire. Next is to show obligation. You must follow these rules. So it is compulsory, obligatory that you must follow these rules. The next model is shall. Shall is used for suggestion. For example, shall I get a pizza for dinner tonight? Means you are suggesting your mother to get a pizza for dinner tonight. Next, offer or voluntary. The bag looks heavy. Shall I carry it for you? Is your offering help? Voluntarily, you are ready to do something. So for that also, we use shall. Next is promise. When you make a promise, you shall be the first person to know. So before anyone knows, you shall be the first person to know your promise. Okay. Next is for confirmation. I shall meet you there at 7. Means you are confirming. To give confirmation, we use shall. Next modal verb is should. So should is used for advice. You should eat leafy vegetables. So it means you are giving advice. Next, for obligation also we use should. For example, you should go to school every day. So it is obligatory, compulsory. You should go to school every day. Next is probability or expectation. To say something is probable or something is expected. It's almost time for class. Our teacher should arrive soon. So now already it is time for the class and it is probable the teacher should arrive soon. So for probability we use should. So I hope you have understood these models. In our next video, we'll see the other model rules. Till then, thank you.